Hello friends, today we'll see the installation process of SpiroTrack Payloader Bucket Load Monitoring System, and we will also see the working process. So this is Liu Gong Payloader or Wheel Loader machine. It's a 5 ton capacity machine in which we will install our loader scale. So inside the operator cabin, you can see our machine which is installed. It has a display unit and all the functionalities. So on the screen you can see it's 0 ton when the bucket is empty. Now the operator is loading the material. And after loading, you can see that the weight is 5.830 ton. This is the first bucket. You can see the count is 1, and the operator can click on the print button so that the print slip gets out. Slip contains information like date, time of loading, material, vehicle number, weightage, etc. So inside the SpiroTrack Payloader Bucket Load Monitoring System, you will get the main unit, oil pressure sensor, position sensor, wiring harness, printer roll, etc. So the machine is made of pure stainless steel for rough environment, and everything is very durable and sturdy. And you will get an inbuilt printer also for the printing of slip. So this is the SpiroTrack Payloader Bucket Load Monitoring System main unit. It's the brain for the entire system. These are the oil pressure sensor and position sensor. And here is the inbuilt thermal receipt printer. So you can see the build quality is very rigid. Inside there is a small button cell battery. Here is the printer. This is the position sensor, and this is the induced magnet which tells the position of the boom. And here is the oil pressure sensor. So today we'll install on Liu Gong wheel loader or payloader machine, which is capacity of 5 ton bucket. So this is a very heavy duty machine for loading the material to the trucks or tipper, Hiva. So the installation process is, first we have to install the oil pressure sensor. So we'll connect at the joint of the oil pressure sensor. We'll use the Teflon tape so that there is no leakage. Now we have to open the joint for the hydraulic oil, and we have to position our oil pressure sensor there, and we have to tighten it very properly so that there is no leakage. So the O type will be at the opposite side to provide the good sealing effect. Everything should be properly tight, otherwise there can be chance for leakage. So now we'll install the position sensor. For installing, we have to make the boom arm 90 degree approx, and we have to weld the strip. So after the welding of the position sensor and the induced magnet, we have to make the position correct so that the distance from the position sensor and the induced magnet is between 1 to 8 mm. So the position sensor has three level, lower, middle and upper. So when the boom arm crosses above the upper limit, then the machine weights the load of the material. So after fixing the position sensor, we have to check whether it is touching or not. There should be some gap between 1 mm to 8 mm. So now there will be three cable. We have to use the tie belt and properly tie all the three cables and take it towards the operator cabin. All the three wire will go towards the operator cabin. And then one 24 volt power supply is also connected to the main unit. So total four cable will be connected to the machine. So now some calibration part is done. So there are various options so that user can set according to the usage and requirement. This is the record management option. Here you can see all the loading history. So now we will do the calibration of the weight. So we'll place the wheel loader machine on the weighing station or weighing bridge. We'll check the weight of the payloader when there is no material on the bucket. So that will be the tare weight. So the tare weight is 18 ton. Now we will load some material like dust, sand, coal, anything, and then weight again. So this time the load is 23 ton. So approx 5 ton load is there on the bucket. So the load in the bucket is equal to the Now we have to weight the material and then calibrate with our device. So our weight was 5.160 ton. So we have calibrated our device and we'll repeat the step for 3 to 4 times for better accuracy. Now the operator will switch on the machine. It will show loading screen and then click on the clear screen. So here you can see everything is zero, the load is zero, and the bucket count is zero. Now this is the first count for loading the material. Operator is loading the material, then you can see the up arrow. You have to move the arm up. So there will be three level, 1, 2, and 3. So after the third position crosses, you can see the weight is 1.140 ton. So this is the first bucket count. The operator will unload the material and then go for the second count. So this process will repeat till the truck or the tipper is fully loaded. So you'll get the total material loaded on the vehicle by the payloader. So the first count was 1.140 ton. Now the operator is loading the second one. So the second one is 4.730 ton and plus the first bucket. So the total count is, total weight is 5.870 ton. Including the first and the second bucket. Now the operator is going for the third load, third bucket loading. Currently you can see the count is 2. Total weight is for the first and second is 5.870 ton. Now the third one is loaded, so you can see the weight is 6.470 and the total is 12.340 ton. So the total load is 12.30 ton for 3 loading. Now the operator will click on the print button to get the print slip. So here you can see all the 3 bucket load, material loaded, date and time, everything is mentioned. Now again the operator click on the save button. So this is the load for the another truck or the tipper. So now you can see the load is 5.830 ton. This is the first count. And click on the print button, it'll give you the print. So the print slip has the date, time, material loaded, vehicle number, load, everything. So with the SpeedoTrack payloader bucket load monitoring, you can optimize your operations and efficiency of the vehicle by getting the data online on our cloud software. You can prevent the overloading of the truck as the operator knows how much material has been loaded. You can prevent the underloading also, because it is a loss for the transporter as the operator knows the exact weight loaded. Thank you.